All right, here comes another request video by my good old friend and longtime subscriber, DS30 Sprite. Yeah, Dirty Sprite, man. So he wanted me to do this video. He really begged me, please do it. And I said, no problem, man. I can do it. What he wants to know, it's regarding to a Roku Premiere Plus. And he wants to see if, in fact, the YouTube app, which is right here, if, in fact, supports native 4K. Because he's in the market right now for streaming boxes. There's so many of them out there, and he's trying to figure out which one's the best for the money, for the value. So I'm just doing this video to let him know that YouTube app does, in fact, supports 4K. And I will show to him how do you know that. So let's click on the YouTube app. Let's do that. There you go. You can see me right there. There I am. All right, so here we go. Now, you see right here where it says HD. Let me get my magic pointer right here. You see where it says HD right here? You know that this is running in HD. When you see this badge says HD, you know right away this is running on a 1080p. Now, on the browsers, when you go to your browser, to your computer, you can click and choose which settings to run the video on. On the YouTube app, that's not the case. It's not the case because the YouTube app is designed in such a way where it already knows that your device, in this case, Roku Premiere Plus, it's already set at HDCP 2.2 output 4K 60 HDR. So it already knows that your device can handle 4K and already knows that your device is connected to a 4K HDR 60 frames per second capable TV. So what's going to happen is it's going to go and detect that. And then if there are 4K videos that are uploaded on YouTube, it will let you know, and this is how you know. You scroll down, for example, let's use the Digital Foundry. There's Digital Foundry, and it will let you know that it supports 4K. Now, I can go to some of their videos, and I can show you. There you go, right here. See where it says 4K? I want to click on one of them right here. I'll click on one of those videos, and I'll show it to you. Now, there's going to be some commercial here. All right, so there it is. It's running in a native 4K. Now, you can see it anywhere. It's not going to show up to tell you, oh, look, it's running in 4K. It's not like that. It's not like in a browser. But you know that it's running in 4K because you already have your device set up to a 4K output, HDCP 2.2. So it's already being run in a 4K because this content, it's uploaded in native 4K from Digital Foundry. So what you're looking at, it's a native 4K from Forza 7. And man, it looks fucking fantastic. This is what we are going to be experiencing on November 7th. And like I said, this Roku Premiere, it's really cool because it really runs fast. It's very responsive. That's because it has a really high-end processor built into it. It has a dual-band 8011.5 something dual band Wi-Fi, so it really has the best of the best. It has the SD memory card. I need to upload some. You see, it says right here, even tells you right here it's 4K, so you know that you are running it in 4K. Hopefully, this helps you, Dirty Sprite, because this video it's really about me just trying to confirm to you that. Look, I'll tell you right now, even though my official review, it's not going to be anytime soon, probably sometime this week, I can tell you right off the bat, if you're not planning on playing any games on Nvidia Shield, if you're not planning on playing any games on Fire Amazon, brother, Roku Premiere Plus, it's an excellent choice for $90. If you can get it cheaper for $60, go with it. But please be aware, you have to buy a Premiere Plus. Only Premiere Plus. Red box, not the orange box, not the yellow box, I'm sorry. The red box of Premiere Plus is the only one that supports 4K 60 HDR. So you want to make sure you look for Premiere Plus. Okay? And it's definitely worth it. And there's so many things I want to say about Roku Premiere. So many things that... Actually, there's some things that I will say on the review that... It's going to make you want to buy it even more. And I'm surprised that Roku didn't advertise this much. I don't know why. Maybe because of the third parties. But there's some tricks and some cool stuff on Roku Premiere that you can do that I think you guys will want to buy this thing even more. Something to do with the Kodi. Something to do with the Xfinity Comcast. I'm just giving you a little hint. And there's some more stuff. But all that will be talked about on my official review of the Roku Premiere Plus, because I'm trying to be as thorough nowadays as possible. I don't want to rush through quick review. I want to spend time before I review something. So anyway, there you have it, Dirty Sprite. Hopefully this helps. Like I said, it's very simple. You just click back. You go back here and it will let you know whether you're watching a 4K or not. Same thing here, Destiny 2 PC at 4K 60fps. You click on it and it will let you know. So there you have it right here. You just go move up on the controller and it'll tell you it's a 4K right there. So you know it's a 4K. If it wasn't a 4K, it wouldn't say 4K. It would say only HD. So you know you're running this in 4K 60. There you have it. This looks phenomenal. Looks perfect. So hopefully this video helps, man. I know it's a short video, but this is only a video by request that I had for Dirty Sprite. There you go. Now, for some of you, if you're wondering, how do you check to see when you're watching a programming on your TV, how could you check and see? Because many people have been asking me, some of you who have LG TVs can't seem to find out, where do you click the display, the info? Where is the info button? How do you get the info button? Well, calm down. The info button is not that simple on the LG. It is simple, but it's kind of like hidden in plain sight. It's not like there's a button you click. Oh, there's the info. So here, let me show you. If you want to find out the info source that you're running on this TV, here's the trick. Here's the trick, Pata. Don't mind, it hurts. Here we go. That was from the Lawrence of Arabia and Prometheus. You click this button right here, on the scroll button, you click on it. You move the scroll button, you move it, you move the scroll button, and then you point out to the corner. You go way up in the corner and then click. There. And once you have this HDMI in source, you click on it. You click this scroll button, you click on it. And there, it will let you know exactly what source you're running is on. 2160p, 16x9, PCM. So that's how you find out what source display you're running this on. And it took me a while to find out too, but this is why I do tests, guys. This is why I'm taking my time to do a review on this TV till June 30th. It's coming out pretty soon. So I want to be more thorough. Like in the past, I used to jump too quick, too fast to do a review, and I would miss some things. And then I would regret for doing a review really quick, really fast. So it's always a best idea to spend more time with the TV, find its weaknesses, find its positives, negatives, you know, stuff like that. So that way, when the review comes out, it'll give you a better understanding on this TV or if you should purchase it or not purchase it, stuff like that. All right, guys. So finally, tonight, around maybe 10 o'clock, you will see that John Wick 2 calibration, custom picture settings calibration for the OLED C7. But please keep in mind, this calibration will only work for LG C7 2017 or any 2017 7 series OLED models from LG. Okay, it will not work on KS8000 because it's a different panel, different system. So I just want to point that out when that video comes out tonight. And by the way, it looks fantastic. Okay, so that's going to be the next video in about like maybe a couple of hours. You will see that. All right, guys, thank you for watching.